You may have heard California is in lockdown, and while that means the majority of us iFixit employees are sheltering in place in our homes, it hasn't stopped Apple from releasing new products, and it won't stop us from tearing them down. Earlier this week, we opened the new 2020 MacBook Air and found a couple of minor changes to the internal layout that were actually very repair-friendly. There wasn't much else to see there, though, aside from the new Magic Keyboard, so we took a couple of pictures, wrote a blog, and called it a day. You can see that post over at iFixit.com. Today, something a little more interesting arrived at our bunker, the brand new 12.9-inch iPad Pro. It's the iPad Apple says could be your next computer. With a new A12Z Bionic chip that Apple claims outperforms most laptop processors, and a new camera system that includes a LiDAR scanner, there's plenty of new tech for us to investigate here. iPads have always been a pain to take apart, but with so much time on our hands, what else are we gonna do? We heat up the display adhesive with our handy-dandy hairdryer, thank you quarantine, then use our opening picks to cut through it. Once the display is free, we're met with a puzzle, but it's actually the same puzzle we found in the 2018 iPad Pro. Two cables about 2.5 inches long attach the display to the logic board, one from near the top of the iPad and one near the bottom. Both of the cable's connectors are covered with screwed-on shields, so accessing them is almost impossible. Good thing we've been playing a lot of Zelda with our time in quarantine, this puzzle is no match for us. The solution is to slightly rotate the iPad to reveal a connector with a bracket on the back of the display, remove the bracket, unstick the cables, and you finally have enough room to access the screwed-on shield. Remove the screws and disconnect the cables, then you have access to the second shield at the top of the iPad. Next, we head straight for the good stuff, the new camera module. The cameras and the LiDAR scanner come out as one big assembly held in place with just a few screws. Here we can see the 12 megapixel wide camera, the 10 megapixel ultra wide camera, and the shiny new LiDAR scanner all present and accounted for. Let's take a look at that LiDAR scanner. LiDAR, or light detection and ranging, works sort of like the True Depth Face ID camera, bouncing infrared light off of objects like tables or fat cats to create depth information. The human eye can't see the lasers it uses, but our infrared cameras sure can. It's interesting to note that the iPad Pro's LiDAR sensor doesn't use as many projections as the True Depth camera on the iPhone. Just look how sparse the LiDAR laser grid is compared to the Face ID grid. Fewer points of light means less information, which explains why the AR capabilities of the iPad Pro still aren't perfect when it comes to occlusion and detecting narrow surfaces. That's okay though, because it doesn't really need the same precision as Face ID since it's mapping room scale objects, not identifying a specific person's face. Like the rear cameras, the front facing cameras come out in one assembly. This is the same basic hardware we've seen since the iPhone X, an IR dot projector, selfie camera, and IR camera. It's slightly modified from the iPhone configuration to fit in the iPad, but it's identical to the array we fished out of the last iPad we tore down. Moving along. Back at the bottom of this iPad, we're relieved to find that the USB-C port is still modular. It's not much for a device that's problematic to work on, but hey, it's something. And that brings us to the end of the relatively pleasant portion of this teardown. From here on out, it's glue and booby trap, starting with the logic board. Like most iPad logic boards, this one is strongly glued in place. Making matters worse, several cables lay underneath it, potentially spelling disaster should the prying get even a little sloppy. The adhered logic board wouldn't be an issue if it didn't need to be removed for a battery replacement, but alas, here we are. On the logic board, we spot the new A12Z processor paired with 6 GB of RAM, a nice bump up from last year's 4 GB. It's been over a year since we discovered the stretch release adhesive tabs on the 2018 iPad Pro's battery, and we're still scratching our heads as to why Apple would include removal tabs for some, but not all of the adhesive under their iPad Pro batteries. This iPad is no exception and is indifferent to our queries as we pull out the isopropyl alcohol and plastic cards to release the last stubborn strip of adhesive along the left side of the battery. This battery has the same 36.59 watt-hour capacity as the 2018 iPad Pro. And that brings us to the end of this stay-at-home teardown, definitely an incremental update for the iPad Pro. While iPad users will enjoy more RAM and a fancy new LiDAR camera, iPad fixers are stuck with pretty abysmal repair procedures. Whether you're replacing the battery, the screen, or even just the USB-C port, you're in for lots of adhesive and some precarious prying. That said, you won't be surprised to hear that the 2020 iPad Pro scores a 3 out of 10 on a repairability scale. Thanks for tuning in to our first remote teardown. Let us know if you have any questions about this new iPad Pro, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to see more teardowns and repair content.